Hey guys, it's QuickyBaby and welcome back to World of Tanks and to a video that's going to be all about why Rampage, at least in my opinion, failed. And if that's news to you, then you probably haven't been playing this game mode very much. It came out late last year. It was meant to come out in patch 10.0 Rubicon, which is meant to be a point of no return, but then they did return on it and they released patch 9.10 instead, which was quite a large patch if you consider that Rampage was an entire new game mode, one of the most polished that Wargaming have ever released. So, that came out in roughly about, I think, October of last year, and now here we are in April, in the last patch that you will be able to access the Rampage game mode. At least for now, they're probably going to take it down, revamp it, but we might never see it again. When patch 9.15 comes, if that's what it's designated as, they're going to remove the Rampage game mode, and when you think about it, a hell of a lot of investment. Now, why has this game mode failed? It looks so good. It looked so good, at least initially, right? You get to enjoy your tier 10 tanks in a different kind of environment from the random game mode with different objectives, as you can see on the map. Here it's capture. Well, it's kind of capture the flag, but kind of a reverse capture the flag where you have to instead take the flag towards the enemy base where they're going to be protecting your capture zone, so to say, or you're defending the enemy's capture zone. So one of the key reasons why Rampage failed, I believe, was because it kind of just came out in this patch that Wargaming, I felt that they just wanted to bury, right? I think they just wanted to release 9.10 and get it over with as quickly as possible, and then release 9.12, and then the patch that they feel happy with now, which is 9.14. And now they just want to remove it altogether. And I can understand why. The initial impression that Rampage had for many players was lackluster, and one of the key reasons I feel was because of the bad credit system, frankly, that's in Rampage game mode. Now, there are many players who are better than me, but I do feel like I'm quite a good player of World of Tanks, and even sometimes I find it hard to make a decent profit while playing this game mode, even with a premium account. Sometimes players can do 10,000 damage in this game mode and pick up multiple kills, and if they've died a few times, they're only going to be getting about 10,000 credits, which doesn't sound like a lot if you feel like you've had a very good game, right? Now, I can only imagine for players who suddenly decided to play that rental IS-7 or the rental T-62A or the rental AMX-50B that's in your garage. We can see that designated by the R standing for rental. And then maybe they lost a few of those tanks and then had like a 40,000 credit repair bill or something. And I can imagine that if that happens to you, then you're probably not going to want to play this game mode again. Especially if you don't have a premium account, which I think only about 25% of the World of Tanks population do have. So immediately, Wargaming really just didn't incentivize us to play this game mode with regards to the credit income. Now, I understand that they didn't basically want to make a game mode that would allow us to get tons and tons and tons of credits that we could then replace the need to get premium tanks with. That's completely understandable. But for it to be so uncompetitive credits-wise for the standard player, I think that was a real big issue. Also, the next big thing was there was no real incentive then to play this game mode, right? Fair enough, you could do crew training for your tier 10 tanks, and if you were a good player, the crew training was absolutely fantastic, especially in the Lone Wolf game mode, if you managed to win it. And let's be honest, that's winning against 10 other players, or 9 other players, including yourself, I believe. Then you did actually manage to get a huge amount of experience. But if you didn't finish top, you didn't get all that much experience at all. So the victor, the spoils, I guess. But when you consider then that there are players who are rather good playing this game mode, consistently winning, I think I had pretty much about maybe a 50 to 75% victory ratio in that game mode, in the Lone Wolf version of the game mode. That doesn't really leave a lot of room for the other 9 players to win, right? So Wargaming's main incentive to play this game mode were the missions. There were a series of 30 missions that you could do, 15 in Domination and 15 in the Lone Wolf version, where you can either play by yourself or in a platoon with 3 people, which would allow you to get a very, very powerful tier 10 Soviet medium tank, the T-22, which frankly was tuned rather high. I mean, I've only ever managed to play that tank on a test account, and I was able to play like a donkey and still have absolutely gigantic games. I've done a full preview video on that tank, so if you're interested, you can go and check that out on this channel. But let me just tell you, the tank is awesome. Especially its side armor, it's so troll, and lots of people just don't understand that you cannot shoot the tank in the side if it's angled at 45 degrees, and that's why the tank is so strong. Now, they made the missions, this set of 30 missions, to be able to get this tank ridiculously hard. Even I haven't managed to be able to do them. I managed to do the first 20 missions in the first 48 hours, but I was trying my socks off, and even getting some help from some people who were often in a platoon with me. So, what people did, because they wanted this brand new overpowered T-22 medium tank really, really quickly, is they started to rig the missions. Now, how did they do this? Well, they signed up at the same time as players, probably on a chat communication program like TeamSpeak, and then took it in turns to be able to complete their missions. And the thing is that because the amount of players playing the Rampage game mode was quite small, especially at certain times of the night, you could reliably get into the same game as all of your friends again and again and again. And what this meant is that you could basically cheat the system, you could rig the system, as it's called, mission rigging, to be able to get this ridiculously powerful tier 10 Soviet medium tank, which is a very, very good crew trainer, the T-22 medium, because it gets a bonus to your crew training, with very, very little effort. Now, what this created was like a stigma on the tank. The first people that had it were either maybe a handful of players who got it legitimately because they were excellent players. But then hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of the tanks started appearing in the random queue, all because people were fixing the missions, which is actually against the terms of service in the agreement that you accept when you make a World of Tanks account. Now, rigging isn't something that only happens in the Rampage game mode. It also happens in the random queue as well. And so that was nothing new, but it was the problem that a much smaller percentage of the World of Tanks population were playing the Rampage game mode, and so it's so much easier to reliably get into the same game to be able to rig. And of course, the fact that the missions for the personal missions, I felt like if you invested enough time into them, you would be able to get them. And you always felt like you had just a little chance. And even if you weren't able to complete the mission, you still got to play the random queue, which is what everyone knows and loves in World of Tanks, right? And so people rigged the missions, and then this created a stigma around the tank. And so that meant that even if you invested a huge amount of time to get it legitimately, then people started to berate you in the game chat, saying, oh, it's a rigger, oh, look at this guy, let's report him, using the automated banning system that Wargaming have implemented. Oh, well, that went well. I heard people tell me, I got the T-22 medium tank, and I got banned because I was reported in-game. I mean, this happens quite a lot, people messing around with the report system to be able to target ban people. And so that's another reason why I didn't want to get the T-22 medium tank. Although I'm sure that I would have been able to stream all my games and show me struggling my way through them. And I'm still thinking about getting the T-22 medium tank in the time that we have remaining. It was a case that even if you did get it, then would you really want that extra drama? Some people were to go as far as to TK people who had the T-22 medium tank. And so another reason why people really couldn't get the missions done is because the games ended so abruptly. Well, what do you mean? Why were they ending abruptly? Well, because of the VP system, the victory point system that Wargaming had in the game that you can see ticking all the way up towards 900 at the top. They stacked it on certain game modes, such as this, which is a single capture the flag, that really the only way to complete some of the missions was to be able to cap the flag. And so you were competing against a whole variety of other tanks where the only way possible to complete your mission was to be able to cap that single flag, which, as you can imagine, is very, very tricky, right? And so what you would find is that people were only trying to cap the flag. And then that meant that there were more flags being capped than usually would happen. And so you found that some of the games didn't last the full duration. Luckily for me, this game went on for a little while, which allowed me to have a lot of fun. And look at that blind artillery strike on the AMX CDC there. Another reason why I really think this game mode failed was because tier 8 tanks. Why? Why should somebody be allowed to take in a tier 8 tank into this tier 10 game mode? Fair enough, I can understand that some people want to play premium tanks to be able to make some credits, because you've made the economy in this game mode very bad, but most of the players that are playing this game mode are doing so because they want to be competitive and they want to enjoy their tier 10 tanks with tier 10 tanks to see who the better team is. And they don't really want to see a Yagpanther 2, they don't want to see somebody trying to get experience on their IS-3 so they can get to their next tier 9 heavy tank, or god forbid people playing tier 8 premiums to make some credits in this game mode, which ended up with having unbalanced teams and frustration for players. So one of the biggest draws for the Rampage game mode was meant to be the fact that you could respawn in the battle and go and get revenge on a player who just took you out. But look what ended up happening. People just spawn camping, right? Look at that gun line that we have on the ridgeline there, you don't see that in a random game mode. And players are forced to respawn and then have to pay credits to repair their tanks that were instantly just destroyed. What an absolute stupid idea that was. And I can only imagine how many players signed up for the domination game mode in their rental tier 10 tanks and then went, you know what, sod this, as they get camped by an unbalanced team. Which brings me on to my next point, the fact that teams were so darn unbalanced because frankly, better players were gravitating towards this game mode. Well, why is that, you might be asking? Why are only better players playing this game mode? Well, the fact that the T22 medium tank missions were so darn hard to achieve, I don't really see the kind of casual World of Tanks player even bothering to be able to come in here to try and do this. And so what you find then is that you get this horrible situation where you've either got very good players who are trying to get their T22 medium tank, or players who are playing rental tanks or tier 8 premium vehicles, creating a horrible mix match that gave an unappealing and frankly boring kind of game mode when you're on the team that wins really hard or the team that loses really hard and then has to pay all of those credits repairing their tanks. So I just played this round today when I was trying to refresh my memory on the Rampage game mode, and boy, we've got an absolute kick-ass medal called Unbreakable, which requires you to not lose any of your vehicles in battle, cause at least 10,000 damage to enemy vehicles, and destroy 5 tanks. And I was able to get 12,797 damage without losing a single tank in this game. And because of this, I made a gigantic amount of credits, and so I guess that's where the problem comes in for wargaming. It must be very, very hard for them to balance this game mode for very good players, who are going to make more credits profit than if they were to play tier 8 premiums, compared to the players who aren't running premium accounts and then get spawn camped. It just wasn't really well thought out and quite poorly balanced, at least economically. So I guess the next question is, can this game mode be saved? Well, I'm just going to talk through a few ideas that I have. Firstly, I have no idea why there was only one tank for this Rampage game mode. And because of this, they made the missions so darn unbelievably hard. Why not just put in another tier 5, 7, and 9 tank before the T22 medium that will be much more achievable for the average World of Tanks player, giving not only unicorns a reason to play this game mode. But if that's too much, then I guess you've got to ask how else you can incentivize in World of Tanks. And I guess it's got to be giving people things, right? If you're not going to give them tanks, it's either got to be credits, it's got to be experience, or it's got to be maybe unique crews or crew training. Another thing that really bugged me about this game mode is that if you want to have a different loadout for a tank that you're going to use in Rampage, you have to go into services and re-put on different consumables for the Rampage in the random queue. I have no idea why you couldn't save a loadout to use in a random tank, or if you're going to play the tank in Rampage. Because the last thing that you want to do is to waste even more credits on premium consumables when frankly you could just respawn anyway. Next, just completely prevent anyone from playing the game mode unless they have a tier 10 tank or if they want to use one of the rental tanks. There is absolutely no need for there to be tier 8 and tier 9 tanks in this game mode, apart from possibly tier 8 light tanks for some of the flag capturing, as well as preventing spawn camping, and then on to really the conclusion, that there was no incentive for the masses to play Rampage game mode, and that's why it failed, wargaming. A game mode won't be successful unless your players want to play it, and the only way to get people to want to invest time into things is either to A, make it fun, or B, make it rewarding. Rampage was really only rewarding and fun for the best players, which are two aspects that I really never want to see in another game mode in World of Tanks. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please consider giving it a like down below. It really helps the channel out. And let me know what you think about the Rampage game mode and whether you agree or disagree with my opinions in the comments down below. And also, just a heads up, for the next week, I am going to be streaming my socks off in celebration of the 5th anniversary of World of Tanks. In addition to my Thursday and Sunday and Tuesday schedule, I'm also going to be streaming on Friday and Saturday, where I'm going to be playing once again with my good buddy Ike, the King of Norway, so you guys are going to want to come along to check that. I'm also going to be trying to play on the Russian server for the first time on Friday and Saturday, so that should be amusing, and I'm going to hopefully have Peppity along with me translating some of the sukobliat that we're going to be seeing on the server. And then on Tuesday, a big announcement, I am going to be playing again with the one and only the Mighty Jingles. That's Tuesday the 12th, and I'm going to be giving away some really awesome prizes, including, I think, 5 Type 59s. In addition, depending on how many kills we're able to get throughout the evening, we're going to be giving away lots of 500 gold and even some 5,000 golds to lucky players who come in and tune in on the live stream. So hopefully I'm going to see all of you guys over these next 5 days for a World of Tanks extravaganza. And as always, thank you so much for watching. You've been epic, and hopefully I'll see you soon.